This video is brought to you by Storyblocks Video. Triple take, master take, and multicam are three different filmmaking techniques. The triple take is where you take one shot of an action, then move your camera and shoot the next action. Master take is where you play the entire scene, shot from one angle, then play that entire scene again from a different angle, etc. The last technique is very nice as you can choose in post-production which angle that you want to take, as with triple take, you can only choose that angle that you've shot. But of course, a master take is gonna take long, as you need to repeat the entire action or scene several times. So that's where the multicam technique comes in. You set up multiple cameras from different angles and focal lengths, and let them roll for the entire duration of the scene. I've shot dozens of dance shows and theater plays in multicam, and editing those projects has always been a little fun, because there's something called multicam editing inside Premiere Pro. Hey guys, Jordy here for Cinecom.net and welcome to Creative Tuesday. So I've got three cameras set up right here. We've got a close-up over there, we've got a medium shot right here, and a long shot over there. When you are in a very controlled environment like here, you can clap like this. And this will give you a reference point to synchronize these three cameras. But what if you're shooting a dance show? I mean, you can't really just clap there right before the show starts. I mean, the audience might think that they need to clap as well, and you're gonna have a hard time figuring out which clap was yours. So for that, I've got a different trick, which I'll get into in a moment. First, let's fire up Premiere Pro and import the three shots from the three cameras. I'm gonna start off with placing every camera shot on top of each other in a sequence. Now, this step right here is only necessary if you have longer recordings and thus multiple clips per camera angle. We can now use that clap to synchronize the different shots. You can clearly see a spike in the audio where the clap takes place. You could also select all of the shots, then right-click and select Synchronize. If there was no clap like here in the dance show, I would search for a prominent visual point, such as a foot of a dancer just hitting the ground or a light that turns on. Synchronize it on that moment, and when you got it in place, you could drag your clips open again. So just keep on synchronizing. Some cameras can only shoot for 30 minutes, so there might be a little gap, not a big problem since you have three or even more cameras running. And once everything is synchronized, we're gonna take the track select tool and select the first track. Right-click on it and choose Nest. Now do that for every track or camera angle. Every camera angle needs to be in a different sequence, which we can see in the project panel. And now we can transform this with a click of a button to a multi-camera sequence. But first, a big shout out to our sponsor Storyblocks Video, which is an incredible online library used by some of the biggest TV networks. Now recently, they've been working on collections of the best quality stock clips available. For example, the Nature Documentary Collection, which are some stunning 4K stock clips that you could even see in National Geographic documentaries. And it's not even that expensive. There's only a single price per year, which allows you to download unlimited video assets from the library, even for commercial use. And besides the stock clips, there are also a ton of more video assets which you can discover for yourself by clicking the first link in the description below. Now moving on with multi-camera editing. We've just put every camera angle into a different sequence. And like I said before, you only have to do this when you have multiple clips per camera angle. When you only have one shot per camera angle, you can kind of skip this entire part. What you then want to do is just double-click on your source clip and set an endpoint where the clap takes place. Do that for all of the shots. You're not gonna have to put them into different sequences this time. When you're done with that, you're either gonna select the individual sequences that we've created for every camera angle or the three individual clips. Then right-click and choose Create Multicamera Source Sequence. Now from the dialog box, make sure that Endpoints is selected as the synchronization technique. From here, you also have that automatic synchronization option, but I'm not a huge fan of these automatic things. With the clap technique, you're 100% sure that you're in sync. And then just press OK. This will give you a multi-camera sequence in your project panel. When you double-click on it, you'll see that you have the three shots are combined in there. Now the cool thing is that you can use this as a new clip. So that means that we can import this multi-camera sequence into a new sequence. And even more cool now is that when we click on the settings button of the program monitor, we can set it to multi-camera. We can now go ahead and just play the sequence, and whenever we want to cut to a different angle, we simply click on the desired angle. and automatically Premiere Pro will add a cut for us right there. So when you're editing a two-hour dance show, this technique is gonna make the editing go a whole lot easier and faster. If you're trained, you could even do this in real time and edit only 2 hours on a two-hour-long video, which is insane. Now, here follows a few tips and tricks when editing in multicam. First of all, when you go back to the settings button, on the bottom you'll find edit cameras. From here, you can enable or disable a camera angle, but also change your order if you like so. Next, hopping into the menu, click Edit Keyboard Shortcuts. In the search box, type Camera. Now, instead of clicking on the desired camera angle, you could also use a shortcut for that. By default, you'll need to press Ctrl plus the number of the camera to cut it to. Now, I would change that to just the number without the Ctrl, or maybe do something else if you like so. The last trick that I have for you involves color correction. Now, don't just color correct in your multi-camera sequence. Instead, open the sequence in which your entire camera angle sits. On top of there, I would place an adjustment layer and do your color corrections on that. If you didn't create it individually, sequences, then simply double-click on your clip in the project window and use lumetri to color correct on the source clip. In your multi-camera project, you will see the entire corrections that you've done, and you can always go back to the source clips to make an adjustment. And that is how you can edit super fast with a multi-camera setup. If you've learned something new, then please let us know in the comments below. I would really appreciate if you do so. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Storyblocks, for the support. And as always, as stay creative.
What are you doing, Jordy? Is that for Friday?